I'm addicted and expensive, Byron Wilcott, and I'm watching WGS-TV.
Hi everybody, this is Double B Billy Boudreau coming at you with another installment of WGS-TV right here on the WGS-TV YouTube channel. And I have a little bit of a topic I want to talk about with you guys today, and it's something I've said for the longest time, and I felt that it's time to finally discuss this. And I know a lot of people aren't fans of Drew McIntyre, but you know, you gotta give the guy his props. I mean, he's talented, he's got good mic skills, he's got good in-ring ability, but the way that WWE is just using him now, they're turning him into the next John Morrison, in a sense, you know? The way is... Go ahead.
You know why they're probably doing that, right?
Well, and by the way, guys, this is Chris Rogers from Rockin Waves 11294. Why do you say that, Chris?
Because they're probably doing this because of that incident between him and Tiffany. If you remember, they were married for about a year, and when Tiffany got in trouble, they also kind of blamed Drew McIntyre for the incident. So, you know, because ever since Tiffany left, it's been nothing but a jobber.
Yeah, and to me, that's just not right, because Drew McIntyre is really talented. He, you know, he was one of the best heels on SmackDown a year ago. He had a great run as Intercontinental Champion. You know, he had that great gimmick as the Chosen One. They move him over to Monday Night Raw to see if he could potentially, you know, do well as a live wrestler of sorts, because we all know SmackDown's always taped. But as a live wrestler, they thought, you know, he had more potential. And, you know, when they made that move to Monday Night Raw, he was just, like, cast aside. Nobody really cared about him, you know? And you don't really want to do something like that. I mean, you know, Drew McIntyre has potential to be a good WWE champion or a good world heavyweight champion. I mean, you know, right now the WWE is in need of really good heels. I mean, when I say that, you know, we got Miz, who's primarily on Monday Night Raw. Dolph Ziggler, who transitions between shows, Raw and SmackDown. And Christian, he's out with injury, so we can't count on him. So you really need a good, solid heel. Mark Henry, he is a good heel, but is he a... would he be considered... Well, Chris, let me ask you this. You know, when it comes to Mark Henry, would you consider him to be a top heel on SmackDown? Chris isn't there.
Oh, sorry. Yeah, I'm here. What was the question again?
All right, no, we're talking about, you know, Drew McIntyre having the potential to be a top heel in the company, and they need more top heels. And one of the people I was talking about is Mark Henry. Do you feel that Mark Henry right now has, you know, can be a top heel, or he just doesn't have it yet?
I certainly agree that he can be a top heel. I mean, he proved it on ECW back a couple of years ago when him and Laughing Boy, I mean, Tony Atlas was on work together. So I think he does have the potential, but can he last? Because if you remember, I mean, he's getting on up there, and the weight catches up to you soon, whether you want to believe it or not. So I'm beginning to think, and we've seen Mark Henry slow down pretty well over the past couple of years. So I think that we may see one more title run with Mark Henry, but I don't think we're going to see him for much longer. I don't think he'll last. So I don't think he'll be a top heel.
Well, right now, I totally disagree with the way the WWE is using Drew McIntyre. I mean, they have him on a constant losing streak, on the verge of being fired on Friday Night SmackDown. And to me, honestly, that is a waste of his talent. Because Drew McIntyre has potential to be so much more for this company rather than just a laughing stock. I mean, look at the people they made him lose to. They made him lose to Santino. And Santino's basically comic relief for the WWE. They had him go against Brodus Clay on the Royal Rumble. I mean, Brodus Clay.
I'm pretty sure that that before long we're going to see Drew McIntyre steal Santino's Cobra bit.
Well, either that or we may see Drew McIntyre out of the WWE and into another company, maybe like either TNA, Ring of Honor, or Dragon Gate USA, because, you know, they're really not using him to the best of his abilities. I mean, you know, they need to really utilize him back the same way when he had his run as, you know, the Chosen One. You know, not to steal Jeff Jarrett's gimmick in WCW, but that's what he was calling himself, the Chosen One. And he had the run as the Intercontinental Champion. And he was a really good Intercontinental Champion. He was a really good heel Intercontinental Champion. He had that ability. You know, he was drawing heat like crazy. And nowadays, it's just not there anymore because WWE just doesn't want to utilize him in that aspect. And I don't understand why. And, you know, it may be due to that incident you said, Chris, involving him and Tiffany. I'm not sure. Maybe WWE saw something at that time, you know, that, you know, he could be a star, and maybe they just don't see it anymore. But to tell you what, I still see it. I still see the potential for Drew McIntyre to be a really big star for the company, and WWE is just wasting that talent. It's just, you know, like it beckons back to John Morrison. John Morrison, incredibly good talent. He has amazing skills. And the WWE just totally underutilized him. Would you say that is a correct statement?
Yeah, I mean, but if you know WWE, they have a hard time letting bygones be bygones. I mean, just take a look at Bret Hart. There was a grudge against each other for, 11 years over?
Since 1997, I believe.
Yeah, so about 13 years. And Macho Man, Randy Savage, Vince McMahon, kind of has, for lack of a better term, got his panties in a wad over Macho Man. So, and I don't remember when that happened. I'm wanting to say 94. So Vince McMahon, it depends on if Vince McMahon is willing to get that stick out of his ass and, you know, say, okay, Drew McIntyre, that what happened with Tiffany's in the past. Let's move on.
Let me pose this to you. What if it's Vince McMahon not calling the shots anymore? It's possible because, you know, they got Triple H really in the backstage aspect of it, really gaining more and more control because Vince McMahon is, you know, I think he's on the verge of retirement from the WWE.
Oh, definitely.
So what if it's Triple H or somebody else that's calling the shots and saying, hey, we don't see what you used to see in Drew McIntyre, so we're going to, you know, make him waste his ability and job to people left and right.
Yeah, I think, if you remember, he was handpicked by Vince McMahon.
Storyline-wise, yes.
Or so they say. Vince may have seen something in Drew that other people don't see. I agree. I think they're just going to job him until Drew says, you know, fall ready with you, mother. Explicit word.
Yeah.
You know, I'm going to TNA or however he talks. So, yeah. I don't think we're going to see him in WWE for much longer.
Now, do you think if he makes a move to another company that it would really be beneficial to his wrestling career, or do you think, you know, he would stay in the WWE just to get the money?
I think it would be beneficial if he moves, because, especially the TNA, because, you know, they have a history for hiring old WWE superstars that have been fired by the company or future endeavor or whatever you want to call it now. And so, if they hire Drew McIntyre, they'd be getting a great talent. I mean, I don't know why people base whether based on how good a wrestler's ability is, based on whether they're heel or face. That pisses me off. I mean, if you see Santino Marella, he's been face for, what, 4 years? And the only thing we've seen him do is Cobra! So, in my opinion, I think the heels have more talent than the faces. I mean, CM Punk, well, he's a tweener, and a bunch of other heels that I can name off.
Now,
but, hey, Billy, I gotta skip out on the video, man.
Okay.
I'll see you later.
Alright. Well, in my personal opinion, guys, Drew McIntyre, you know, if they want to keep him in the company, they really need to give him a really good push. Whether it be for an Intercontinental title, or a United States title, or maybe one of the big two major titles, you know, it remains to be seen. But at the current rate they're going, you know, they're making Drew McIntyre, who used to be a really good talent in the WWE, a good Intercontinental champion, and they're just turning him into a flat-out joke, and I don't think that's right. I don't think it's right whatsoever. You know, the WWE, they really don't know how to really utilize their talent anymore. I mean, you know, when it comes to certain ones that have the potential, Drew McIntyre has the potential. John Morrison had the potential, and what happened with him? They blackballed him over something that happened with him, Melina, and Trish Stratus at WrestleMania. And it's possible, you know, what Chris said, the reason why they're possibly blackballing Drew McIntyre, you know, not letting him, not utilizing him to the best of his ability, is possibly the incident that happened with him and Tiffany. We all know Tiffany's not part of the company anymore, and that happened nearly a year ago, almost. But the WWE, they're just not doing a very good job, and I would hate to see Drew McIntyre leave the company, but if they continue to make a joke out of him, you know, as talented as he is, if they continue to make a joke out of him, you know, I think it would be really beneficial for him to leave the company and go to someplace else, like maybe Ring of Honor or Dragon Gate USA or Ring of or TNA. You know, someplace where they can actually utilize him for his talents. You know, don't have him just job to people left and right because of a backstage incident or something like that. No, allow him to be what he can. You know, really a really talented heel. Now, I've never seen him as a face, so that remains to be seen if he can be a really good face character. But, you know, he has proven to me that he can be a really good heel. And if WWE just continues to make a joke out of him, he needs to go. He definitely needs to go. And it would be in WWE, I would kick you right in the face because you'd be letting a really good talent leave the company all because you're blackballing him because of a backstage incident. I mean, you've already done it once with John Morrison, and I hate you guys for it. And you're probably going to be doing the same thing with Drew McIntyre, and that's just not right. That's just not right. That's been my piece on Drew McIntyre. I want to know what you guys have to think on the situation involving Drew McIntyre. You know, would it be beneficial for him to stay in the company, you know, knowing that he's just going to be jobbing left and right instead of, you know, being utilized properly as a really good heel? Or would it be more beneficial for him to go to another company where he can be properly utilized for his talents and his abilities? You know, because he does have good in-ring abilities, he has good mic skills. I don't care what anybody else has to say. You know, if they want to mad dog me about it, please go ahead. But I definitely want to know what you guys think on this situation involving Drew McIntyre. You know the two ways to do it. You can either leave your comments in the comment section below or in a video response, your thoughts on Drew McIntyre and what needs to be done for him to either stay in the WWE or would it be more beneficial for him to move to another company where he can be properly utilized. So that's what I want to know from you guys. Again, leave your comments in the comment section below or in a video response, your thoughts on Drew McIntyre and what a push really be good for him to stay in the company. And don't forget, if you liked everything I had to say and Chris had to say in the video, and you liked everything you saw in this video, do me a favor and hit that like button. And don't forget to subscribe. So with that being said, I'm Double B Billy Boudreaux saying thank you very much for watching.